Yes, and then we enter. We go into the valley of Stalingrad. Right here. I don't plant any trees, but that's because it would defeat the purpose of calling it a valley. And welcome to the great valley of Stalingrad. Big puppies, pack of dogs. These are all my dogs. These dogs are mine. Born and overbred. All the cows died. Stalingrad. Then we go into the... What do you call this? A skeleton slaughterhouse. And I made it. Yes, I did. And the changers are still janky. And I'll explain that later. But here's the skeleton spawner. They just drop down from there. Then I put a whole playlist called The Wall of Sound. Very old, they're old songs. They're still very good. And now, yes, skeleton spawn. Let's go down here. I don't know why he went up. And then there's a lot. There's this systematic thing of where the hoppers all drop into this chest and into that chest, and down here it gets inventory arised. Goes into the inventory, then it becomes the inventory, and becomes inventory arised. It's a very simple thing. I know it looks complicated, but it does. That's the job well. And now we go past the sign of Stalingrad, which is right there. There you go, Stalingrad. I have this little birch forest with barely no leaves on it. And we go to the field of flowers, and we reach this very utopian looking lake with an island of animals and a house in the wall. Now it's a very nice secluded place because it's in between two, well, the other one's higher, between two mountains, and in between is a nice lake. And here are the animals. And I'm going to this house because I personally built this house with my own bare hands. Okay, so when we enter this, there are four rooms, okay? Over there, and over there, and over here. And this room is called the guest room. And the living room, and there is a TV. I don't know if you want to call this a TV, but it is a TV nonetheless. And Ken is sitting on top of that chest, which is quite annoying. And we have this folding tables, very neat. Upstairs we have space for two guests. No one lives here yet. Yeah, that's the first room. The second room is the storage room. This is where everything goes. Not much to say. That's the job. Go into this room, which is the kitchen, undoubtedly. And yeah, it's a very nice looking kitchen, 5x5. Every room in here is actually 5x5. Making it very compact, you know, I designed this, you know. I didn't want to over-design this house, I just wanted to get it done and have four rooms. It looks very simple. It's up to the person who owns the house to design it. Put banners all around here if you want it. And last but not the least, here is the bedroom. There are a lot of cats in here. The owner is a very cat fanatic. And there are chests up here, and somehow I cannot open these. Okay, we're back in the server. There's nothing in these chests. I don't know. The owner doesn't want to put anything. And it's a very personal thing. I shouldn't have gone in there. And soon and hopefully I will put a secret door behind this painting. So I can put an enchantment table. Very simple house inside. Have you seen the roof? It's a very nice looking roof. You know, I wanted to keep it realistic and have a support in the middle so that it could support the house. I mean, I tried to kind of make it look realistic, where there's a support beam in the middle, and you know, it's very supported. And then there's a beam running across this whole thing, and that supports the rest of the house. Now I try. It's pretty good. There's a window up there, as you can see, but it can't be reached. It's just there for design. And if we go outside the house, you can see. You can't see because there's two trees. There is the window up there for the roof. Jasmine plays MC's Mountain Rock House because it's built in the mountain and that took a lot of stone in the actual place. And as you can see, we have this little tiny randomly generated rock here, and I put a bridge and it looks actually quite nice. And I put ladders up here so you can get up there easily. And it looks pretty mice. It actually looks pretty nice. This could be you can make a diving board here. And then just you can jump in the pool. Yeah, if we get down here, you see a little nice path here. I personally made this little tiny rice kind of a terrace wheat farm here. Very nice looking, nothing much. And you see this nice wheat field. And if you go in here, you actually have a very private pool area, and you can renovate this if you want. Yeah, you can put torches around so no zombies. And see, I purposely put two stacks so you cannot go up. Very nice and cozy, very cool. And let's get out of here. Let's go back to our house. Our house, it's my house. I gotta say, this is the best location ever in the whole world, as I have seen so far. You know, my sister is very lucky to have this spot right here. You know, in between two mountains, and you have a very nice, glorious lake. And you have an island in the middle that is actually man-made, if it's not been obvious yet. This is a spot where I would like to live, but unfortunately, I did not live here because I already had a house and I was too lazy. So I just gave you a new house. This is actually a very nice spot, and the thing that I like about it is next to her house, there is a flower field, and she can have access to that. And we're back at my house. It's a very cozy house. You know, there's not much. There isn't much to this house. You know, it's the practicality that I'm after. I'm not putting a CR or a TV. It's just the things that I need to survive in the world, because it is survival after all. Now, if we get into my house, get away from the door. If we get into my house, you can see there's a little tiny garden for my bees, and this bee cannot get out. I have this very nice fireplace. I can use this for cooking plants. What do you want? I don't even have a flower for you. Get back to your hive. Now that we're in this house, you can see it's full. I have all the chests. I used to live with another person, but sadly he doesn't play right now. And in here is my private bedroom, and here's the meeting table for some reason. And I have a lot of discs. I got this from a disc farm, legitimately. And here's my bed. Very cozy. What do you call this? There's like a chandelier. I'm gonna call it a chandelier. There are these granite support beams that will support the roof of the house. Yeah, and that's pretty much my house. Very practical, nothing too fancy. I tried to go a little bit fancy, but you know, it's not much. It's just some vines and some stuff. And you gotta meet my pets. Here's Nigel. He's my postman. Okay, I carry him. I go with him in case I want to send mail to people. Sadly, you cannot ride them with those. Because Mojang won't let me ride the camel. Oh yeah, the Nether, I forgot. Now, we haven't explored the Nether for the fact that 1.16 might release around the corner. It hasn't released yet for some reason. Everything, every single building that you have seen here, from big to small, everything here was made in survival. Isn't that great? If we can do it, you can do it too. You don't have to go in creative. You know, it's very nice to work hard for something. You know, it has that very nice rewarding feeling if you build this. Look at this. Look at this castle, bro. You can never make something like that. I never glorified these. This is huge. This is really nice. If you look at it from the back. Just look at it. That is huge. A very grand and majestic castle.
The looks of it, it's only the gate, bro. And already I feel intimidated by this, so for real though, shout out to the dude that's making this. Right there, shout out to this dude. Right there. It just looks so good. Oh, that is massive. Incredibly massive. Very nice. That looks like a farm. Yeah, it does. Moving on. Last and certainly not the least is... it's his house. Right there. Right there. Okay. Now, as you can already tell from the front, it's a very intricate designing thought process was put into this. Look at it. Very... now there's a lot of little bits and pieces that I feel like if it got damaged by an explosion, it's kind of hard to fix, but it's a very good entrance. This house goes into the wall, and there will be like several rooms that connect to the central hallway. You'll see once you go inside, my goodness, you'll be so shocked. Now, once you go in, you can see that design from the front of the house carries its way in to the interior design of the house. And I can say it actually looks very, very nice. You can see storage compartments on the right and the left in the hallway. Very organized. There's this carpet on the floor with a crafting table. There's some practical use to the crafting table being in the middle, and it's also part of the design. You can see right from the walls. Now it feels non-linear, except for the hallway, of course. It's a straight line, obviously, because he added these layers of slabs and I guess stairs, and it just feels more cozy to me because of that. Now, if we go in, this is the end of the hallway. And there's a painting at the center. And there's a lectern. And left and right, there's a room. Is this the right? Yes, it is. If we go into the right, this is probably the bed. Very nice. There are some bushes in the walls. Very nice, very cozy, very rustic in design. So I'm guessing that's the stuff. And here's the bed. You know, the funny thing is, no matter how big your house is, everybody's bed is the same. Just pointing that out. And here's the very decorative armor stand right here with three weapons pointing directly at the armor. Very nice. And yeah, he added a wall clock, which is also nice. Very cool bedroom. Now, if we go here, I guess this is the food storage. Looks of it, presumably. Assuming. Hesitantly. If you go look around, very nice here. Very, very nice. Crafting table. Practical placement. Very cool. Wow. Okay. That's all I said when I went in the room, because it was so good. Now, if you look into this room, it just looks really cool because it's a small doorway. Then when you go in, you just gotta kind of take your breath to look at everything. This whole room is based around the enchantment table. This is really nice. Yeah, it is really nice. Very cozy. Very nice. I'm really just trying to say literally anything, because I really can't say it anymore for the house. It's just, it's really good. You know? And not saying anything about it wouldn't really glorify how good the house really is. Shout out to the owner of this guy's house. It's a very well thought out house. The house near the lake was actually inspired by this house. And, you know, I couldn't even replicate the internals of this house. It's just so good. And, yeah, it's just so good.
To end the video, if I see a chicken anywhere, if I see a chicken within my sight, I'll end the video. Now let's go find the chicken. And